Let's go. You need to do better than that. There's the buddy running. That's hurt. You're just weak. Here we go. What?
Good find, BD. We'll get around faster now. Let's go, BD. Another stem. Here you go. Here we go.
What are you fishing for?
I'm hunting the ferocious me. Did you know the me was the very first fish we scuba caught?
That must have been quite a day.
Aye, I was barely yee-high back then. Little scuba swam headlong into the creature's mouth. Lucky as I was, I couldn't digest me before fishing fellows pulled us out.
Sounds more like it caught you.
It takes me back. Stick it in, boy, and I'll top us off with a tale. The tale continues. When we last spoke, I warned of the Grapnel's arrival. That great ship came descending on us like an anchor cutting the deep. Ne'er a more fearsome ship did you clap eye on. She was sharp, like a fish, like the nose of a bony fish. She had three great claws. Aye, the landing gear. But when her great jaws parted, aye, the loading ramp. Now, will you hush and let's go and tell the story? Her great jaws parted, disgorging her dread crew. A more vile pack of fisher folk you never did see. And led by the vilest of them all, Captain Wan Yek Wet, the bearded vessel is bad that he intended to fish in our waters. Trophy hunters they were, in search of the most rare catches. Well, we Sakavians refused. We had the great famine to contend with, see? Every fish was precious. But the ferocious captain didn't care for our troubles. With a belch, he produced from his creel a mighty harpoon. Wait, cried wee scuba, hopping off of his rock. I know these waters like the taste of my own tongue. There'll be few fish beneath yon ice. But, continued I, if you take me with you, and if you leave my village be, I could show you how to coax the rarest of fishes onto your line. Aye. The dread captain stroked his briny beard. After a long moment, he held out his hand and grinned most terribly. Lad, said he, you be in luck. I'll be requiring another from a crew, one who knows the curve of the sea. Oh, Cal, if I could only go back to that moment when I shook Captain Wet's rigid hand, if only I'd never stepped off my wee rock. But my encounter with Undan had given me a taste for the unknown. I couldn't resist the call of adventure, and I had to save my people. So, I left with the Grapnel, thinking the business done. I would be a fisher for Captain Wet. Of course, my adventure had only begun. For just when the Grapnel hit orbit...
More trouble, I take it?
Ah, but I've havered on long enough. I come back another time and I'll tell you more.
Nest of shiverpedes. Oh, Grease is gonna love this story.
Oh. Moving to sector. Wait, what's that? Looks like it's from the clone. It's incoming!
Not much to look at.
Buddy, help!
Imperials. Just gotta keep climbing. See if Doma's interested in this.
Thank you.
More priorite. We can trade this at Doma's shop. Raiders have the Empire spooked. This could get pretty ugly, BD. His ability's pretty bad. Gotta push through. Energy conduit. You don't have anything for it, do you? Is that an Imperial shuttle? I don't know why they were flying in such poor conditions. Want to check it out? Must have been thriving here once. Now it's a ghost town. Keep your sensors running, BD. I don't trust this place. I knew something was off. Looks like another shard. Nice. I hear you, BD. Let's see.
me. Here.
Help, Sim.
Hey, buddy.
Seems we gotta climb the rest of the way. Safer than going on foot. Trying to keep things hidden. Toss me a stem, buddy. Stopping us, huh? Nice. Seeds. Bet Peely can tell us more after we plant them. Found another shard.
brain.
Pretty big force sent to secure a shuttle. Must be something inside. Dart? Next time, maybe run a scan before you start firing. Here. On you, beat. Let's keep moving, buddy. Thank you.
Stim here, BD.
Thanks, buddy. Something's up there. What's this? Let's go, BD-1.
Stim!
Come on, buddy. That's a lot of firepower. See him, BD. Then please.
The last of them. Should open the door.
I should. What?
This is an inspection. You have orders to let me pass.
This Apologies for detaining you, sir. I'm sure you'll find everything up to code.
Let's hope so. Weak minds don't stop them from conquering the galaxy. Let's move, BD. Do what you gotta do, buddy. If this garrison could hold against a raider attack. I know. Who would you want to win? The Rancor or the Gundark? Okay, this is high. Way down. Come so far. Fire away. Force is with me. Time to move.
Boat, we're heading to the observatory.
Already on my way.
Thank you. view. You'd have liked it, Shanna.
Fine, buddy. These look modded. Probably for the high altitude. I bet Z can get the data off this disk. Eyes on Daggett.
Roger that.
Already tore through here.
Ah! some action. Looks like a big firefight up ahead.
We'll manage.
Good luck. Looks like I've got a raider on my tail. Gonna shake him.
Need to center myself. All right, let's go. I bet Z can get the data off this disk. Doesn't work from here. I'm sure Z can decrypt this for us. Edie, help, please. Get a stim, BD.
Thanks, BD.
forces with me. Let's move, BD. That was close.
With the observatory.
What? We're just following orders.
Just a pawn? Do you carry a communication device?
Yes.
Activate it now. My name is Dagon Gera. Your attack here has failed and your soldiers' lives are forfeit.
I did what you asked.
All right.
Can't go wrong with more stems.
You kept me waiting, Jedi. Dagon Gera chose me to end your pathetic little life.
And your master chose poor me.
Your man, hit me again. Try that again. Gera! What's yours is mine.
Everything he has in us, huh?
The skies are empty. I don't like it.
He might have found the compass. We gotta hurry.
Agreed. Circling back. See you soon.
That's not moving. Here's our man.
Sorry to keep you waiting. Had to swat a few bedlam flies to make a landing.
No problem. We got a whole swarm of them up ahead.
You ready for this, brother?
Let's get that compass.
about cleaned out of here, huh?
They underestimated the Bedlam Raiders.
Dagon may be delusional, but he's got an army that believes in him.
They think he's taking them to Tantalor.
My dead body.
Incredible. Just incredible.
We caught one as he tried to escape.
Please, I surrender!
This is the army that ended the mighty Jedi Order? Kill him.
Look at this tech.
You know, my daughter loves gadgets.
Yeah?
Her favorite is this black market scanner I took off a Hutt enforcer.
What a mess of a father I've been.
Nobody's perfect. I'm fighting to give her a better life.
You're right. All of this is for her. But we're not too late. Dagon gets off planet with a compass.
He flies out of here and we never see him again.
Make sure that doesn't happen.
Where are all the raiders?
Oh, I don't like the look of this.
We're nearly at the top.
No going back now.
Focus.
You sure you want to push that button?
Do we have a choice?
All right, let's do this.
One for you, one for me.
I kind of need to share. Look. Good job.
Ready, Cal?
Yeah.
Enemies nearby.
I just need combat strategy. Target damage.
Here, bud.
Let's adjust our aim.
Think you can jumpstart that thing, BD?
to center myself.
Hostiles!
Freedom.
got your back, brother.
Not getting through.
Get it back.
Help me, BD.
Barely felt it.
Knock it off.
It's over. Just more pain for you. Okay.
Already? I've lost count. Can't get through. Jedi stuff. Don't worry about it.
Show off.
please. Let's change the angle. Observatory is up ahead.
Right behind the army of Bedlam droids.
Ah, are so dead. Understood.
Time to show them why we're the best. Keep pushing. No holding back now. Yeah.
I'm ready. How about you, BD?
Too late.
If Centauri had only stood with me, we could have convinced the Council that Tanalore was worth the sacrifice. Now she's gone. Ravus is gone. The Order is gone, and I am free!
You're not free, Dagon. You're alone.
Why are you here when your true enemy is out there? How could you let the galaxy fall to this unworthy machine of an empire? You think yourself a survivor, but you are a failure!
They haven't beaten us. Not yet.
Now who is blinded by the past? Within the Abyss, the Empire cannot reach us. I will forge these raiders into an elite army led by disciples trained in the Force at my temple. Then, when the time is right, I will strike out and cleanse this galaxy with fire.
We've already got an Emperor. Give us the compass.
And why would I do that?
Because I'm a father who's running out of options. And you're standing in the way of a better life for my little girl. You hand it over. I will put you down.
What small dreams you cling to. Enough! Tanalore beckons. You're an embarrassment. Your demise is inevitable.
Nice one, brother.
Chained by the past. If we were great.
Fight me! Bleed!
just one final act. Your skills are an insult.
I'm game if you are.
Still chained by the past. If we agree.
You're an embarrassment.
You're terrified. Time for your new one.
Did what the Order was too weak to do, and for that she betrayed me.
I'm simply bastard.
Fight me.
Watch this.
Stop me.
Hey!
pathetic. How does it feel to know that you're about to die? That your life meant nothing? Don't resist. You can't hide from me. Ah, yes. I feel it. Loss, suffering, shame, anger. There's immense power in such emotions, but you were too weak. And now it's too late.
Are leaving. I will not return. You're lost. You've strayed from the path. And you are no Jedi.
You!
Kind of force hallucination, fueled by fear. I use his against him.
not so scary now. It's still in one piece.
BD?
Give me some good news.
Maybe Dagon was right.
You sure you're not still, you know?
Think about it. Tantalor's a fortress. We should use it for the hidden path. Gather allies, train. They'd never see us coming.
I don't know, that seems risky.
Everything is at risk so long as the Empire's around. Besides, you don't want Kata spending her whole life in hiding, do you?
If she's safe, Cal? Then yeah. Yeah, I'll take that.
Yeah. Yeah, okay, I understand that. But someday, someone's gonna have to face the Empire. Why not us? I bet Cordova can fix this up. Let's head back to Jeddah.
Sure. I'm gonna take a look around first, see if I can find a manual for that thing or something.
We'll figure it out.
Yeah.
Hey, buddy. You saved my neck. Again. Thanks.
You go ahead, Cal. I'm sure the crew can't wait to hear the news.
Meet you back at the Mantis.
Don't think we can slice that.
Cow, ahoy! Step in the lot. This one's a rare catch indeed.
What is it?
The fabled Farfish. Its tail is one riven with greed, soaked to the bone, with tragedy. There are scant few far left, on account of their succulent glands. But I do not intend to harvest the poor creature for its organs. going to bring it back to the saloon, where I might one day find a mate for it.
Playing matchmaker, huh? You found another fawfish before?
No. But fishing's about leaving the world better than you find it. A ripple's only as good as the stone you cast. Now for a tale, lad. So, you wish to hear of a time on the Grapnel with the crew of the dread Captain Wanyak Wet?
Let's hear it.
Aye. My tenure began with quite a bump. The moment the Grapnel hit orbit, her klaxons began to sing. A barrack ship full of lawful types swung out to the stars and hailed us. What be the meaning of this? Growled our captain. We're simple fisher folk. Your transponder codes tell a different tale, came the reply. You be standing on stolen property, you do. Aye, you've rightful caught us, said the captain. Come on aboard, and I'll surrender what was stolen. But scarcely had the lubbers set boot on the deck of the Grapnel, when wham! The captain's harpoon skewered them like a quailfish on a spit. Now you can't do that when you're running line, can you? Said the captain to me, grinning in his foulsome way. I'm sorry to say that I picked up the harpoon that black day. For years, I did not toss a fish back into the sea when I caught her. Well, that is until... blubbered you to death. I'll continue my tale soon, lad.
Focus.
I believe what almost happened to Z.
Things worked out okay in the end.
Thank the stars that you could help her. Back in school, one of the archival droids was destroyed in a power surge. At the time, all I could think about was how much it screwed up my holoprints. How blind I was.
Don't beat yourself up. We're all figuring things out day by day.
Cal, I've been meaning to, well, I was a little curt when last we spoke about how my shipping operation was shut down.
Don't worry. I've heard worse.
I really did lose everything, you know. And everyone. That's what brought me to Koba with what few wares I had left. Monk lets me keep my things in the back room. Go on. See if anything suits your fancy. Not like anyone here has credits to spend. Anyhow, I shouldn't take my troubles out on you.
Thanks, Moran.
Do you ever miss the glory days, Cal? Cut and thrust, the rough and tumble.
It sounds like every day. Not that it's glorious.
Well, I certainly had some glorious years. I'm sure I never told you about the incident over at Munalinst.
Don't think you did.
I was personally escorting a shipment of, let's call it a sensitive luxury product. Unfortunately, we were accosted by a customs longship. The Fensign failed to update our transponder codes and our vessel was marked. Well, push comes to shove, and we were boarded. I've got three customs officers waving blasters under my nose, so what do I do?
I throw on the waterworks. Oh, Cal, you cannot imagine. I'm swearing up and down about everything from past marriages to lower back pain. Almost worked, too. But one pesky officer decided to kick open a shipping container full of the slightly incriminating powder.
Guess the jig was up.
Oh, Cal. Cal. You're looking at a professional. I told them that they were looking at the ashes of 1,000 ritually cremated Sereno war heroes. And by the stars, they bought it. The inspectors actually bought it. That, Cal, is why I'm here instead of rotting in a Munalinst work camp. Another time.
Enjoy the tunes.
We'll talk soon.
You ever get homesick, Tulot?
From time to time, there are quite a few things I miss.
Like what?
The many rivers, Velati trout leaping over the current, and the food that I crave.
Oh, yeah?
Handmade dumplings stuffed with potato and kushnet. I miss the taste of banzon, a minty spice that enlivens every taste bud.
You should talk to Grease. Maybe he can whip something up that reminds you of home.
A wise suggestion, Sojourner. Now is not the time to speak.
Kestis putting the kibosh on the Raiders? Look at you!
I doubt they're gone. Just a little bruised.
Still, I'm impressed. Without a leader, they're gonna lose a lot of oomph.
Yeah? There's an open spot at the top of the Raider ladder. You interested?
No thanks. Too much heat. But you're right. If I had to guess, something big and mean is gonna swallow up those Raiders.
Don't like the sound of that.
I didn't think you would. You're on a roll, Cal. Got another tip for ya.
What you got?
A bounty droid named Mesh has been babbling on the brood comms about that lab on the Shattered Moon. Go shut him up, will ya? They're a disgrace to the profession, if you ask me.
We'll see about him. Sooner or later.
Attaboy. You got the stuff? I got the goods. Whatever.
All right, you old bat. I'm in.
There's the bonehead I know.
Barkeep.
Good to see you, Cal.
Everyone holding up okay, Monk?
Well, we're just fine now. The Raiders might have put a little spook in some of our clientele when they marched in here, but we're made of sterner stuff.
Good to hear. You doing all right?
Cal, my boy, I'll tell you the same thing I told those Raiders.
What's that?
Go ahead and shoot. But know this, you'll be blasting the best bartender on Kobo.
See you later, Monk.
You stop the Raiders. Well, you're not the only one with amazing news.
Oh, yeah?
Brace yourself. I found a shell.
Well, look at you. A shell. That's great.
The symmetry, the hand feel, the way it stays cool in the Kobo heat. It all keeps me calm.
Really happy for you, Turkle. Just don't tell anyone else. Don't want them to get jealous.
That's a good point. I'll keep it to myself. Promise. What a day. You saved the outpost. I found a shell. Things are looking up.
A bartender's job is never done.
Cal, just in time. The old grouch just made the best decision of his life.
Yeah?
Uh-huh. I'm done pounding sand. Reckon we're ready for a big score.
The big score. The one we've been waiting for. Sitting right under the imps' noses. Got a tip about some derelict Imperial equipment up on the mountain. Prospectors have been too yellow to go for it. But we ain't yellow.
We sure ain't.
This time tomorrow, we'll be sitting pretty on an industrial fuel injector.
Glad to hear someone's not letting the Empire scare them away. But you need to be careful up there.
Oh, we got it all figured out. Got a map and everything.
Better get our autographs now, Cal. Next time we meet, we might be above your pay grade.
See you when I see you. So come on, kid. What's next for you?
I've got a chance to find someplace safe. I plan to make good on it.
Well, I'm no good with advice, but, people who... Hell, I messed it up. I'm just trying to say, listen, the happiest folk live somewhere between what they want and what they got, you know?
Yeah, I hear you.
Really? Sounds to me like the old man's noodle is starting to fray.
Damn it, Dana, I was being... forget it.
Anyone tell you about the Mogu around the swamp?
There's a Mogu there?
Yep, and this one's a whopper. It can snap your arms off like puerco sticks.
We'll see.
Well, if you're crazy enough to try, your best bet is to avoid its mud throws.
Good tip.
So you got the compass, yeah? Well, guess that's it. Next stop, Jeddah, and then, you know, rhymes with Manowar.
Sure you're ready to leave Pylunes behind?
Well, I gotta admit, it's in good hands. And this ain't a one-way trip. We can still visit, right?
Just have to be careful.
Sure, sure. I was more of a risk-taker when I was younger. These days, I just want a place to call home.
Grease gets anxious around dirt.
Cal, when we were fighting Dagon, those hallucinations, what were they for you?
My friends, suffering because they followed me. And I couldn't do anything to stop it.
I saw Kata in her room, stormtroopers coming for her, breaking down the door. But you know what? That's not gonna happen.
Yeah. Thanks for being there and having my back.
No. Thank you, brother. We're closer than ever to giving the people we love real safety.
Par, right? You said you're from around here?
Been all over Koba. But I knew I had to foot slog it back to the Reach when I heard the stories. They say it's been a right barnyard since you arrived.
Word traveled that fast, huh?
If it's privacy you're worried about, mate, don't be. No one listens to old Har. But stop by if you ever want to hear the latest yarns, eh? My eyes what they are, I couldn't hit a tree with a boulder. But I got ears like a boolean. Oi, Cal. Good to see you.
I know it's not much, but it's home.
Hush now. This outpost is absolutely quaint. But perhaps it could use a new coat of paint.
Cal, what do you think?
Yeah, why not? I bet people would appreciate it.
I can help you hook up the wiring.
Ooh, it's a date.
Great to see you.
Not now, dear.
How do you like Pylunes?
It is like an oasis. A dirty oasis. Tell Grease I said that and you will regret it, droid.
How you feeling, Z?
Much improved, Cal. Now that I am far from that ghost. Ship.
It's seen better days, that's for sure.
The same could be said for the entire galaxy, could it not? But it is heartening to see that some bright spots yet remain.
That's why we keep fighting.
Indeed. I must say, I see vestiges of the Order, my Order, in you and your companions. It is most heartening.
Sometimes you know just what to say.
Care to see what I've found? Yes, that's worthy of your attention.
Here you go.
Excellent selection. Farewell, my friend.
Garden's nice and lush these days, huh, BD?
You've introduced a new species. After you plant it, I'll provide more detail. I see you found new seeds. Plant one, and I'll tell you all about it.
Want to plant some seeds?
The garden resonates with you.
This is a new one. I bet Peely has more information. Let's clear that space. Good spot to grow.
That fruit show will be wonderful when it flowers. The wide-brimmed leaves provide shade for the thin stem, which can blister in the heat very easily, you know. That fire pineapple will bloom, I am sure of it. Cut past the roots, and the fruit beneath is quite delicious, if you can endure its pungency. Just you wait for that golden light moss to grow. Observe the roots that rise up underneath, helping the flowers to reach nearby light sources. Oh, hello.